Joining me today is someone from Rifle, Colorado, a fitting name, the owner of Shooter's Grill, and frankly, about the toughest 5 foot 1 inch lady I've ever met, Lauren Boebert. And Lauren, you're there at the grill. It's right behind you, yes. And you got customers. And
here we are. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Well, glad to have you. Last week, you kind of had some fun, and I'm jealous that that I wasn't a part of it, at least at the event. And we want to bring our members in on what you did and and showing up at presidential candidate Beto O'Rourke and frankly giving him the business.
Yes. Yes. So I heard that Beto was coming to Colorado to speak on gun control. And as soon as I heard that, I said, absolutely not. You're not going to come to my state and pander my people. Of course, we had just heard him say, hell yes, we're going to take your AR-15s and your AK-47s. And I think everyone's immediate response to that was a solid, hell no, you're not. You're not coming to take those from us. You're not touching our Second Amendment. You're not even polling more than 1%. So you're not doing anything, sir.
Which is funny, Lauren. You said what everybody in America was thinking. Hell
no. How could you not? Yes. I mean, what other response to that is? He actually said during his speech that he was speaking with many conservatives and Republicans and that they were so excited about his plan and they would willingly and eagerly turn in their AR-15s to him. And like, I seriously doubt that.
Oh, I was just packaging these weapons up behind me.
Yes.
Because I would willingly hand those over to Beto O'Rourke.
Right, here you go.
He asked for them, they're yours.
Is he allowed to have them with his criminal record? I don't know if we're allowed to give them to him.
I'm sure he'd pass a Brady check.
Right.
The thing he ties onto. Why? Why did you go do it? I mean, was there some motivating factor? I know, but tell everybody.
So we accidentally stumbled upon this Second Amendment advocacy being Shooter's Grill. And so we have been a voice for the Second Amendment for some years now, just about five. And anytime I have an opportunity to stand up and defend what's rightfully ours, I will jump on that and take hold of that. But really, when I went down there, we are the majority and we're so quiet that we seem like the minority. And it's really time for all of us to rise up and speak up. And so I knew that I had to be heard. I was going into the lion's den, but they heard me roar.
It was funny watching the video and seeing you, little gal, right there in the center of all these sea of people,
yes.
Most of whom were, you know, flaming at the mouth communists, largely from Boulder,
yes.
And who, if they saw an AR-15, they might piddle their pants. Unless, of course, it was law enforcement coming to save them.
Right.
Then yes, they might be okay
then
with
it. Then it's okay. And the open carry is okay in that circumstance as well.
Yeah. Well, law enforcement's open carrying.
Right. Yes.
But, you know, they want to demonize that weapon and of course, he wants to demonize not just AR-15s, he wants to demonize any weapon, and he'd like to confiscate them all. We know.
Yes.
Are you like me? Do you feel like, hey, finally, they're admitting it? We always know they wanted to do this.
Absolutely. And, you know, even Evan Todd was there. He's a survivor of Columbine. And he was there and he kind of baited him. And he said, hey, don't you know that semi-automatics are actually the weapon that's used most largely in circumstances like this? Are you going to take those too? Because that's what you need to do. And I mean, of course, he kind of stumbled on himself and was afraid to say it. But he did say this is a great starting point.
Lauren, you're standing in a big group of people when you did that,
yes.
When you brought that up. And, you know, many of them were probably from Boulder. These were people on the far left.
Yes.
But weren't you happy to hear them finally admit what they really want to do, which is they don't want to just regulate. They don't want to just pass red flag. They want to confiscate our firearms.
They absolutely do. And their ultimate goal is complete control and tyranny and socialism. They want to take our firearms. And that is the bottom line. Beto kind of pandered the crowd and said that people like me are, it's sad that we live in such fear that we're going to take their guns. well, that's what you're saying you're going to do. And well, really, if you listen to Beto, you know, he says a lot of things, because just last year he said, that's your personal property. You bought it, you own it. We would never take it from you. And I was like, yeah, absolutely. We're going to buy it back from you. It's not ours to buy back, but we're going to buy it back from you. And if we don't buy it back, then we're going to confiscate it. So he doesn't know what he's talking about anyway. He changes with the wind. But ultimately their goal is to do away with the Second Amendment, because how can they have ultimate control if we have the power? They can't.
Well, and here's the odd part, that in the situation we're in now, and this is very common in Washington, D.C., is the Dems push a very, very draconian bill, and then Republicans settle for half of it. And,
yes.
And right now, that's what's happening in Washington, D.C. In fact, one of the memes we're running is that U.S. Senator Pat Toomey, who's a Republican from Pennsylvania, and tried Toomey Mansion back in 2013 when Obama was president, is trying to pass universal background checks again with a Republican president. And we're making the claim, your confiscation, or I'm sorry, we're saying Pat Toomey's universal background checks is what enables Beto's confiscation. You can't confiscate guns you don't know about.
That's absolutely correct. And honestly, I am one of those who is absolutely tired of the Republicans bending. We need to stand firm and keep a hold of what we have, what's rightfully ours. We don't need a president who's going to give them an inch. He stands firm in everything else that he says he's going to do. And he says, I'm going to do it. I'm going to get it done. And we're not going to watch him bend over the Second Amendment. We're not going to cave to red flag laws. They're absolutely unconstitutional. And, you know, the left never bends any direction that we want. So why would we do that for them? Absolutely not. This is our time. This is our time to reign and get our country in order where we need it to be. And we're not going to say, okay, well, you know, we won't be so harsh. We won't be so strict and everything. We'll give you a little bit. No, absolutely not. This is our time.
You're hired.
Thanks. Right. I have a job.
Yeah, you got a job. You have a grill to run and kids to raise.
Yes, four of those.
But Lauren, you're on point, and which is one of the reasons we wanted to have you on, is we know you're really solid on those issues, and you know that us giving a very small amount means we're going to lose everything.
Everything. Yes.
And I tell everybody, rewind back to 1992 to the presidential campaign, and I was working in politics back then, and Republicans used the Brady bill itself, the Brady background check system that we're under now, as the litmus test to decide whether you were pro-gun or not. Well, guess what? Right now we're talking about expanding it into private sales and guns that your grandpa hands you.
Yes.
And so how far have we come? And the reason we came is because Republicans caved.
Yes. And no more. No more.
And that's often how we get gun control, is basically by people who claim they're with us caving.
Right. And or they just call it gun legislation because it's not so controlling. But, you know, I mean, I run my business the same way. There's a lot of people that say that I should not take a political stance with my business. And, you know, there may be people who don't support us for that, but I still support them and their rights. And I would rather lose a few customers over a stance than lose everything that I stand for. There is no way that I'm going to sit back and be quiet and watch all of my rights be absolutely stripped away. I have been blessed with a platform, and I'm going to use it to speak on behalf of the rights that I've been endowed with by my creator, and on behalf of millions of Americans all over.
Well, you've made a name for yourself in the grill, not just in what you did with Beto, but you've been doing that for a while.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of Americans know about it. Certainly everybody in Colorado knows about Shooter's Grill.
Yeah.
And it's kind of this iconic spot. And it, to those people who don't know, describe the area you live in.
Well, in Rifle, Colorado, we are just a Western town. We're a hunting town and a very tight-knit community. We have 9,000 people, and we pretty much know everybody's name. I love Rifle, and everyone here, you know, they have their guns. when we first started carrying, they didn't care that we had guns because theirs were bigger, theirs were better, and at the time, they could shoot better. So we have improved on our accuracy, I'm proud to say. But, you know, it just really wasn't a big deal because it really is a way of life here.
Right.
And so that's rifle.
And what's your elevation there?
We are at 5,300 some odd feet.
And to many people who don't know that area, they need to understand you're in the foothills of mountains every direction. Mm-hmm. And there's some of the world's best elk hunting is all within 90 miles of rifle.
Yes.
Most of the people in town hunt or certainly eat the food that came from the hunt. And yes. And so I know it's like Shooter's Grill is a destination spot mm-hmm. for people traveling in that area, especially hunters. And now you probably put it even more on the map. So
yes,
with
yes,
that,
I've been getting a lot of attention.
I want to thank you. And what I'm going to do is invite you back on to do some more commentary, because I think this gives our members and listeners and followers kind of a taste for a real American, not a Gucci loafered lobbyist, not that I wear Gucci
right.
loafers, but I am a lobbyist and a real American mom's views mm-hmm. from a very rural part of the world. And,
yeah.
And I think they can identify with that. It makes sense. They look at the people walking through your grill and go, yeah, I walk in one of those every day.
Yes.
Maybe not yes, with
no
all
one,
the guns on the
no
hips.
No one is afraid here.
Yeah, maybe not with all the guns openly carried on the hips. Not everyone does it quite like Shooter's Grill, but.
Right.
So, thank you, Lauren, and God bless.
Maybe one day they will. Thank you so much, Dudley. Thanks for having me.
All right.